What's going on, guys? It's Risky here. Welcome to an H1Z1 video on my channel here today. And in today's video, I'm going to be telling you guys about some upcoming features that Daybreak has announced on their webpage. I will leave a link in the description to this website, which is their h1z1.com/news/PS4 open beta. But if you guys want to go check it out for yourself, be sure to hit that little description button and go down there and hit that link, man. If I remember, I probably will. But yeah, getting right into this, it says right here on the website, let's talk a bit about what's coming up next for H1Z1 on the PS4. Launching an open beta means we're still squashing bugs and collecting copious amount, copious? I don't know that word, copious? I don't know, my amount of player feedback. During closed beta testing, we identified several performance issues we are still working to address specifically. As it relates to team modes, with today's open beta launch, Solos 5's combat training will be unlocked for play all day, with duos to unlock later this week once we've implemented and tested additional performance improvements. We'll need your help once duos unlocks to let us know your results. That's one thing I really want into the open beta, guys, is duos, because me and my friend, we're doing really, really good at just duo fives. Like, we can get to the end, but then we just get rushed by a whole squad of five dudes, so it's kind of, we can't really do much about that. Where else, where was I? It says, yeah, in addition, here are some other near-term features we're working on. More than a few of these are based directly on feedback we've received during closed beta testing. So the first thing that they say right here is revive. Currently, duos in five matches have no revive mechanic for picking your teammates back up, and once they've been hurt, which can be a bit punishing for new players, we're working on bringing a console-specific version of the PC revive mechanic to the PS4. Which is really nice, because if you guys did not know, if you are playing fives or something and you get killed, there is no knock. You don't get knocked like Fortnite or PUBG. You can't get revived. So once you die, you die. You gotta wait the whole game, which isn't terrible. It's not like you gotta wait an hour or anything, but it's kind of annoying if you just die from some stupid reason. Aim acceleration. Currently, when you move your joystick, the speed at which your character moves and responds in a linear or acceleration, which led to some feedback that movement and aiming don't feel very responsive, which, in my opinion, it honestly doesn't. It's just like you gotta move your stick so much. Like, the dead zone is very, very high or low. I don't know which one that would be, but it's just like you gotta move your stick so much to where it actually starts moving. I'm not sure if that's what they're putting in here, or I'm like getting into the wrong idea of what they're saying. But yeah, we're working to implement a non-linear curve solution now, similar to the other shooter games, to give you that more responsive feeling. Grenade throwing and responsiveness. Thanks to the players who shared their feedback and bugs during closed beta testing, we've worked to resolve many of the sticking issues with grenades. We're not done yet, and we will continue to improve the system during the open beta. They also state that they will be bringing some more frame rate improvements. I have seen that the closed beta was not the best. It was super, super laggy for a lot of players, but I also have noticed that the open beta is just way better. It's honestly super smooth. Every now and then you'll get a little lag spike or whatever, but other than that, it's really, really good right now. But this is an important one, and we pushed an update during closed beta to help address issues seen particularly in team modes. We are continuing to work on even further optimization to bring you an even better experience on both the PS4 and the PS4 Pro, which is why we're currently stress testing solos, fives, and opening duos later this week with additional improvements. The next thing that they say is swap weapon slot. We're working to provide a way for weapons to swap a weapon into their preferred slot location. For example, when you pick up a shotgun and it defaults to your left slot, we want to allow you to be able to move into your bottom slot. Keep in mind that this will still require you to have the slot unlocked slash open in order to move a weapon there. In parentheses, it says you'll need to have looted the correct backpack already in order to access those slots, such as like a blue military and whatever. I think that's the only two backpacks in the game. I'm not sure. They're also implementing, this is one that I really want, like I want them to add a tactical layout like Call of Duty, where you hit down on the stick to crouch instead of the circle button. And I also want them to add it where you can hit square instead of triangle to loot things, just because I'm used to Fortnite and it feels a little bit quicker where you can just move your finger over to square instead of all the way up to triangle. But yeah, it says multiple controller layouts. We're working to support several different preset controller layouts so you can pick which one fits your playstyle the best. They're also adding in an EMP grenade. Too many players left in cars, not if the EMP grenade has anything to say about it. Once implemented, this new throwable will shut down cars within a radius for a short time. I honestly kind of like that for in-game situations, so you don't have a bunch of people running around in cars at one time. This next big one here is kind of crazy in my opinion. It's called the airstrike grenade. Dropping this throwable will call in an airstrike at its location for maximum destruction. Don't stand near the flare, by the way. So yeah, I don't think they had that in the PC version of the game, so it, correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm pretty sure that's something completely new to the H1Z1. But that sounds pretty crazy in my opinion. Just throw a flare at a big group of dudes or something and just freaking let them have it with an airstrike. I think that's pretty crazy. But yeah, that's basically all the news I have here today, I believe. Let me scroll down a little bit. Yeah, guys, that's basically all there is here. If I do get any more information and some release dates on when all this stuff will be coming out, I will be giving you guys some more of those news videos like I have been doing, because all of my H1Z1 news videos have done really good. My gameplay videos, not so well, I guess. I don't know what I'm trying to say. But either way, I really appreciate all the support on these H1Z1 videos that you guys have been giving me lately. All the support on the channel, all the new subscribers, welcome. And you guys, if you did enjoy this video and found it useful, be sure to drop a like, subscribe, stay tuned for more H1Z1 on the channel, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Later.